Breaking news. In just minutes, the House of Representatives will vote on the Senate's version of a bill to address the humanitarian crisis at the border. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi saying the House will pass the bill, but more progressive members of the Democratic caucus are slamming the decision, including Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez from New York, who joins me now. Congresswoman, thanks for joining us. You tweeted, quote, "Under no circumstances should the House vote for a McConnell-only bill with no negotiation with Democrats. Hell no. That's an abdication of power we should refuse to accept. They will keep hurting kids if we do." Those are strong words against Speaker Pelosi. And that bill, as you know, passed 84-8 in the Senate. A lot of liberal Democrats voted for it. Explain why you're taking such a strong stance here.
Because, you know, Jake, this is an issue not just of the substance of the bill, but also the process of how we got here. We passed a House version of this bill, which had far more humanitarian provisions and accountability for the facilities that are abusing kids at our border. And Mitch McConnell immediately smacked it down in order to pass and ram through a Senate bill that has an enormous amount of funding for military, as well as no guardrails and no accountability for facilities that are abusing our kids. So that's the bill that's in front of us here in front of the House. However, we didn't even bother to negotiate. There are House amendments. We could have negotiated it in. We could have conferenced. We could have tried to get amendments in to get humanitarian provisions put in, to get consequences for facilities that abuse kids in. And instead, what we're doing is that we're immediately going to just saying yes to what got passed out of the Senate. And these are two completely different dynamics. The Senate, you have a minority Democratic Party there. And here, we are the House of Representatives, and we are a House majority, and we need to act like it.
But, Congresswoman, didn't you vote against the House version, too?
I did. And the reason that I did as well is because I understand you had Julian Castro right before. He disagreed with even the House version of the bill, as do I. I do not believe that we should be throwing more money to ICE. My district is 50% immigrant, and I have an obligation and a responsibility to protect them. I believe that really what we should ideally be doing is passing a pure humanitarian bill to get money straight to those kids. No tricks, no riders, no poison pills. We need to get toothpaste, toothbrush, soap, and we need to make sure that these kids are protected as well as having their resources funded. And the fact that this is even a game is frankly a huge, huge disappointment.
Well, if you oppose the Senate bill and you also oppose the House bill, I guess I'm wondering what it is that you're willing to support that could pass in either the House or the Senate.
Right. And once again, I think that a pure humanitarian bill could pass. I do not believe that Republican voters are interested back home in preventing kids from getting toothbrushes and toothpaste. Pass just the money for these kids. In addition, if the president wanted to, he could declare an emergency right now and get that money to those kids. Because right now, what he's able to do is he's able to put billions of dollars from the Pentagon, withhold funds from getting dispersed in Puerto Rico in order for him to build an inanimate wall. But he will not lift a finger in the same capacity in order to get toothpaste to those kids. So I think that what we can do, A, there's that provision with the president, but also what we can do is pass a pure humanitarian bill. But you know what? Even if it came down to it, if it came down to brass tacks and we had to negotiate in an imperfect bill with House amendments, that at least is better than the situation that we have right now.
But I guess my point is, isn't your desire for your vision of this bill? I mean, there are kids, as you point out, and the Department of Homeland Security Secretary Kevin McAleen, and he's been warning about this for months. Mm-hmm. It's going to be overcrowded. We need funding. $3 billion of the $4.6 billion is going to housing for kids, for migrant kids. I think another $800,000 or so going to housing for other undocumented immigrants, adults. By opposing both bills, mm-hmm. aren't you just ultimately depriving these kids of housing facilities that they need?
Well, when you look at how both of these bills happened, Jake, I think it's important that we have members of Congress that stand up and actually call truth to the situation. The House bill passed resoundingly. There were only four Democrats that defected, including myself, from that bill. And the reason I defected is because I needed to send a message to my constituents and my folks back home. And in fact, my constituents asked me to vote no on the bill. But if it ultimately came down to it, if we needed 100% every every single Democrat to vote on this bill, we could do it with the amendments. But the problem right now and the question at hand right now is that Mitch McConnell sent us a bill and we're just putting a big check mark on it instead of even trying to negotiate. I have indicated that I'm willing to stay here. I don't need to go home on vacation. I don't need to go home to July 4th weekend. I will stay here all weekend to make sure that we get this thing done. And instead, what Mitch McConnell is doing is that he's relying on the time pressure of recess to try to ram through a bill that is completely irresponsible to the American people and to those kids on the border.
I want to ask you, last night you tweeted, quote, "Last week we called the concentration camps at the border for what they are. In the week since, the acting director